I think it's important for us to be able to give arguments for God's existence without using the Bible. Now, I believe it's important that we can quote the Bible even to unbelievers because the Bible is the Word of God and it can persuade and touch the hearts of those and convict the conscience of those who do not believe it. But I also believe if someone does not believe the Bible, it's important for us to be able to give arguments for God's existence without quoting the scriptures. Now, we see Paul model this in the book of Acts, chapter 17. In Acts 17, he went to Thessalonica and he reasoned with them using the scriptures. Why? Because they believed in the Old Testament scriptures. After that, he went to Berea, and the Bereans had a high view of the Old Testament scriptures, so they went back to check to see what Paul was saying was true. But later in the chapter of Acts chapter 17, when Paul comes to Athens, he meets these philosophers, Epicurean and Stoic philosophers, who do not believe in the existence of God the way he did. And so what he's going to do is he's going to talk about the existence of God as a being who's distinct from what they're worshiping. He's going to point out some similarities and saying, what you're worshiping into this altar to an unknown God, I'm going to proclaim to you. So let me give you three arguments now for God's existence without using the Bible. Think about the acronym G-O-D. We're going to first argue that God is the best explanation for a standard of G, goodness. If God does not exist, objective moral values do not exist. If God does not exist, what may be right for you may not be right for me. But since we can agree that there is a standard of things that are really good and those things that are really evil, we gotta ask ourselves, where does this come from? Is it in some impersonal Platonic forms like the philosopher Plato believed in? Or could this standard of the good be the first cause of the universe? When we think about this standard of goodness, we think about God because God is the ultimate standard of goodness. Now, C.S. Lewis in his conversion, if you read the book Mere Christianity, he's going to say that as an agnostic, he looked at the injustice in the world. But he says, how did I get this standard of being unjust unless there's a standard of justice? A man doesn't know that a line is crooked unless there is a straight line. So you can reason to the evil of the world to point that there must be some standard beyond us that is the standard of that which is morally good. And that's what we mean by God. God is the infinite, perfect standard of goodness. The O in the acronym G-O-D stands for origins. God is the best explanation for the origin of the universe. Think about this, the Kalam cosmological argument that says everything that begins to exist needs a cause. Premise number two, the universe began to exist, therefore the universe needs a cause. We can argue that God is the best explanation for the Big Bang. He's the best explanation for time existing, for matter existing. Ask the atheist this question, why is there something rather than nothing? And if the universe did come into existence, it takes more faith to actually believe that nothing caused it to come into existence rather than affirming that something or someone caused it to come into existence. So God is the best explanation for the first cause or the origin of the universe. The D stands for design. Astronomer Hugh Ross identifies hundreds of examples to show that the universe is finely tuned. Some call this the anthropic principle. For example, the size of our galaxy is perfect. If the Milky Way were larger, infusions of gas and stars would disturb the sun's orbit and cause many galactic eruptions. If it were smaller, there would be an insufficient infusion of gas to sustain the star formation. Similarly, the oxygen and nitrogen quantity is just right for life. If there were more oxygen, plants and hydrocarbons would burn up too easily. If there were less oxygen, then advanced animals would have too little to breathe. Given these hundreds of other examples of precise fine-tuning in the universe, it is most probable beyond a reasonable doubt that an intelligent designer was involved in the creation of the universe. So we can use this acronym to say, look, even apart from the Bible, God is the best explanation for a standard of G, goodness, O, the origin of the universe, and D, the design in the universe, G-O-D. So these are arguments that you can give to an atheist. You can briefly cite them like that before we look to the Bible. Because if God exists, then miracles are possible. When we talk about God, we can talk about a being who is a mind, who has the ability to communicate to us because he is very powerful.